So this is not clickbait. This computer literally cost me $99 to build. Last year, the idea popped into my head, just how cheap could I build a computer for and it still be able to play games? Now, obviously that's a pretty loose criteria, so I just kind of started collecting computer parts that I saw when they were dirt cheap. And 8 months later, what you're about to see is the result. Let's get right into it. First thing we're gonna talk about is the solid state drive. I saw an ad pop up on Craigslist for a $20 used solid state drive. Now, if you pay attention to sales, you will notice solid state drives tend to go on sale at cheapest for $25 for a new solid state drive. So I decided as soon as I saw this one go on sale for $20, I'd pick it up because it was by far the cheapest I had ever seen. Met up with the guy and he was actually kind enough to let me go through and sift through some of his stuff. He didn't really seem like he wanted to sell a lot of it, but he was nice enough to sell me a solid state drive mount for $2 and a SATA cable for $1. Now for the RAM, I have 8 GB of DDR3. This is a Kingston HyperX Blue and it is actually a very quality piece of RAM. I bought this RAM in December of last year. I have someone local to me in town who I met through Craigslist who actually gives me unbelievable prices on DDR3 RAM. Now for the CPU and motherboard. This was actually another amazing deal that I got through OfferUp. Someone was selling an old collection of their old gear that they didn't want anymore. I saw the motherboard and CPU as a part of the picture, and I asked if I could just go for that instead of the whole lot. We went with a lot of back and forth until he finally said that he would sell me the two for $30, which is an unbelievable steal. Going into it, I actually didn't know what I was buying, but based off what I could see, I guessed that it was some kind of old AM3 processor, which it was. I'll put the model name on the screen. AMD didn't exactly make their old Phenom model names really easy to say. Now for the case, I actually got this last year over Black Friday. It was micro ATX size for $10 after mail-in rebate. Now for the power supply, I was actually browsing through Build a PC Sales subreddit, which I highly recommend you start following. And someone posted a link to an Amazon sale on a power supply for $12. Now obviously, if you're gonna build a computer for yourself, do not ever, 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 ever buy a power supply for $12. The reason I say that is because it's going to be a power supply without any power certifications, it's not going to be brand name, and you're not going to know who made it because it's probably white labeled and EVGA, Corsair, just go for those. And finally, for the graphics card. This was the deal that completed everything for me. I was looking for something incredibly cheap and I didn't know what I was gonna get. I thought I might have to go with one of the old AMD cards or something from Radeon. And then out of nowhere, I went on Letgo and saw that somebody was selling their 550 Ti for $10. I offered them $5 and they accepted it. The caveat is when they sold it to me, they said it had been in storage for a year and they had no idea if it worked. Now, for $5, I figured I was gonna take that risk no matter what. Now, when I got the card, it was actually in the worst shape I had ever seen for any used part I had ever purchased. It had dust everywhere, and I'm not kidding when I say this, when I was cleaning it, a bug literally crawled out from the casing. Anyways, that's enough talking about the parts. Let's get into the thing that you guys are here for, and that is the benchmarks. We'll be right back.
have to go.
I don't know about you guys, but I am blown away by how well this computer performed on all of those games and tests. Now, a last couple of few things I want to talk about in this video. This is actually, for a lot of reasons, also one of the worst budget builds I've ever made. And the reason I say that is because this is 100% something I will not be selling. If I give this away, that's something I'd be fine with, but I will not sell this to someone. Here's why. When I was doing testing, the graphics card actually would spike at 84 degrees Celsius. For those of you who don't understand computer gaming, the highest you usually want to see your graphics card go is around 70 degrees. And that's usually only happening when you have a top tier card, like a 1070 Ti triple fan or a 1080 one singular blower style fan. For an old 550 Ti, that's clearly showing that these games are way too demanding and the graphics card shouldn't even be put in a situation where it is playing those games. To make it worse, 84 degrees was as high as it got with the side panel off of the computer. I tried closing the side panel to do tests and I actually started to feel the heat from the computer through my wooden desk. So while this computer is able to handle all these tests and games at an exceptional performance standard, it's not something that can actually stand for a long period of gaming. However, if we're looking at the positive side and the thing that I really wanted to accomplish, $99 can actually bring a lot of bang for its buck if you know what you're doing when it comes to budget building. So, in the end, I hope you guys are satisfied with this video. I think it was a really cool project. I've had so much fun with it. I think it was more than worth the 8-month wait to finally have everything for a reasonable price. And ultimately, I'm just hoping that you enjoyed the process as much as I did. Anyways, I wanted to say thank you guys so much for watching. The channel has been growing at a rate that I really never even thought would ever happen. So, I mean, just thank you guys so much. I'm glad you appreciate what I'm doing. I do it, you know, for myself because it's fun, but I'm also enjoying doing it for you guys and seeing a fun response. So thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, have a great day. Oh, and we did the giveaway stream. So for the winners, you have up until June 5th at midnight to claim your prizes. If you don't do it, I'm gonna do another stream to give away whatever has not been claimed, but you have to reach out to me through my Discord. I'll leave all the information in the description. Yeah, that's the end of it. All right, bye.